yesterday we have studied about structure. Yesterday we have studied about the structure of anther in tears. Structure of anther in tears appears somewhat like this, and it divides into two parts. That is, the wall of anther, which is made up of epidermis, endothelium, middle layer, and tapetum. Tapetum encloses a pollen sac, or it surrounds pollen sac. Pollen sac contains a pollen mother cell. This pollen sac contains pollen mother cell, which are a diploid one. This pollen mother cell divides by a meiosis cell division and gives rise to four haploid microspores or pollen grains. That four haploid microspores or pollen grains are known as male gamete. Now, today we are going to study about a structure of this pollen grain. Structure of a pollen grain. Keep it in mind, pollen grains are produced in the pollen sac from pollen mother cell by a meiosis cell division. Then a structure of pollen grain. Each pollen grain is a circular insect. Each pollen grain is a circular insect, and it is covered by two layers. That layers are known as a sporoderm. That out of this two layer, outer layer is exine. It is generally rough or variously sculptured. It is a thick, variously sculptured, and this exine leaves a small opening or certain thin areas. That thin areas are known as germ pore. And this exine is made up of a special chemical. That one is known as a sporopollenin type of chemical. This sporopollenin type of chemical avoids decaying of pollen grain due to the environmental factors. Now next one is, inside the exine there is a presence of inner layer. That inner layer is known as the entine. That entine encloses cytoplasm and a nucleus. Nucleus is a haploid one. Thus each pollen grain is somewhat circular in shape. It is a unicellular, uninucleated haploid. Now this one is a structure of pollen grain, which are produced from pollen mother cell by meiosis type of cell division. Now next one is, we are going to study a development of male gametophyte. Now male gametophyte develops from a pollen grain. Male gametophyte develops from a pollen grain. Now each pollen grain is structurally, you are knowing, structurally it is a unicellular, uninucleated, and haploid insect, generally circular insect. Now next one is, during development of male gametophyte from the pollen grain, the first pollen grain, when present in the pollen sac in the anther, divides by mitosis cell division, and gives rise two unequal cell. This one it divides by a mitosis cell division and it gives rise two unequal cell. A larger cell is known as a vegetative cell. And smaller cell is known as a generative cell. Now next one is, well, at this two-celled condition, pollen grains are released out from the pollen sac or from the anther, and they are transferred on the receptive stigma of a female reproductive organ. That process is known as a pollination. It means that at this two-celled condition, a pollination takes place. Then after pollination, pollen grain deposits on the receptive stigma. Then at this two-celled condition, pollen grain when deposits on the receptive stigma, it absorbs mucilage from the receptive stigma and it swells and finally bursts open through the germ pore. Then entine comes out in the form of a tube. That tube is known as a pollen tube. Then content of the entire migrates in the pollen tube, that is cytoplasm, and at the same time nucleus of a generative cell divides by second mitosis cell division and gives rise to two non-motile male gametes. Now pollen tube contains cytoplasm, two non-motile male gamete, and nucleus of tube cell or nucleus of the ventive cell. Now all this together, that is a pollen tube, cytoplasm, two non-motile male gamete, and a tube nucleus, together forms male gametophyte. In this way, development of male gametophyte takes place from a pollen grain, and it completes in the two step, that is before pollination on the in the pollen sac and after pollination on the receptive stigma. This one is the development of male gametophyte from unicellular uninucleated haploid pollen grain. Keep it in mind, a male gametophyte consisting of parts like a pollen tube, cytoplasm, two non-motile male gamete, and tube nucleus. Here, development of male gametophyte is completed. Now we are going to study a next bit from the same chapter, that is a male gametophyte and structure of ovule. Development of male gametophyte is completed here. Now we are going to study about female reproductive organ of the flower. Now a female reproductive part of a flower. Now which is the female reproductive part of the flower? Now yesterday we have studied that female reproductive part of the flower is a gynoecium. Female reproductive part of the flower is a gynoecium. Now the unit of a gynoecium is, now the unit of gynoecium is a carpel. Unit of gynoecium is a carpel. Now carpel consisting of parts like a stigma, then a style and ovary. Out of the stigma, style and ovary, ovary is the fertile part, and this ovary produces a number of ovules. Ovary contains number of ovules. Now these ovules are produced from the placenta of the ovary. This one is a placenta of the ovary. Now carpel is the unit of a gynoecium, unit of a gynoecium, and each carpel consisting of parts like stigma, style and ovary. Now ovary contains ovule, hence it is a fertile part. Now ovule develops from placenta of the ovary. Now in this way, the female reproductive organ of the flower is known as a gynoecium. Unit of gynoecium is known as a carpel. Each carpel consists of parts like a stigma, style and ovary. Ovary produces ovule as a female gamete. Hence, ovary is known as a fertile part. Ovary is known as a fertile part. Now, we are going to study next one, is that is the structure of ovule. As ovule is produced, all of you know, ovule is produced in the ovary from the placenta of ovary. Now in angiospermic plant, ovule is generally inverted ovule. That structure of ovule we can study in the next lecture.